G'day guys, Adam here. Here in Australia, we live on the driest inhabited continent on the face of the earth, with people mainly living in the capital cities, but some of us in the regions. The continent is made up of over 200 freshwater catchments, each with their own unique personalities. Some are really wet and some are really dry, but most are somewhere in between. Most of you will be familiar with the Murray-Darling system. It's like Grant Denyer, always seems to be popping up on our TV. Unlike Grant, it's our largest and most productive catchment, riddled with its issues. The main one I can see from afar, without talking to the people involved, is that there's way too much water held upstream inefficiently, often to the highest bidder, which means there isn't enough for the downstream communities. But today, guys, I don't want to talk to you about the Murray-Darling. Instead, I'd like to introduce you to Central Queensland's largest catchment, and indeed the largest catchment to drain into the Great Barrier Reef, the Mighty Fitzroy River, Doorumbal country. Our major problem up here isn't a lack of water downstream. It is a case of way too much water downstream and nowhere near enough upstream. The river on average discharges approximately 5,900 gigalitres of fresh water to the reef, or more simply, 12 Sydney harbours. In 2011, however, we had one of the largest flooding events on record, with 3.8 billion gigalitres entering the reef. Again, more simply, 7,600 Sydney harbours. To top that off, on average, the Fitzroy discharges about a megatonne of soil a year, which equates to about a billion kilograms. Or if you will, 100,000 truckloads. If the trucks were to form a line, it would be from Brisbane to Mackay, bumper to bumper. Estimates of sediment transport, they vary widely, but I reckon any sediment entering the reef that has originated from our farms is just way too much. The sediment carries with it nutrient, pesticides, herbicides and plastics, all damaging to the reef and its inhabitants. The sediment also buries our coastal marine seagrasses and corals, which are essential habitats for the majority of our juvenile species. The freshwater goes even further afar, venturing hundreds of kilometres up the coast, introducing nutrient and chemicals to the reef, throwing out the balance of the system. So what are we left with? It's farmland, scoured of much needed soils. The water has no time to soak into the environment. Instead, it simply rushes downstream and ends up in a place it's not meant to be, burying a national treasure. But guys, I'm an optimist. Our river and reef, they're resilient, just like us. Water in Australia and indeed the world is a precious commodity. So why allow it to simply pollute our Great Barrier Reef? The sediments in the catchment are ancient, some of the oldest in the world, and needed by our landscape and farmers. So why simply allow them to bury our beautiful seagrasses and corals? We need to find a balance to give back the river and its farmers some of the water and sediment and give the reef some relief. Over the next few months, join me in a series of podcasts where we'll talk to traditional owners, fishermen, farmers and academics, all focused on trying to improve our current situation. I think together we can become a more productive and predictable catchment whilst improving water quality to the reef, allowing it to do its thing, guys, like it has for thousands of years. So let's work together to help keep the barrier reef great. If you have any interest in farming, mining, or our aquatic environments and want to study or support CQU, get in contact with us in the link below and tell them Adam sent you.